Welcome to round 18 of Monsters of Destruction here on the Outdoor Channel. We are at the Evergreen Speedway in Monroe, Washington. A capacity crowd on hand to see 9 trucks in MOD competition tonight. We'll start with qualifying, and the first truck on the line is Jason Grill. This will be a single run. We've got 9 trucks, so somebody's got to go by himself. Tonight it's Jason Grill in front of his hometown crowd. The green light falls. He hits the gas. He's got a good run going here. Slap wheelie on the landing. That'll slow him down. This is not going to be a strong qualifying run for Jason. His time, 8.136 seconds. That mark will probably be beat by one of our other 8 trucks competing here tonight. Next up in qualifying, it's Lindsey Wink in the Iron Outlaw. Wink made a good impression in his first action last night here at Evergreen Speedway. Running with him will be Brad Campbell in the Monster Moves. Both of these trucks qualified at about 7.3, 7.4 seconds in round 17. Let's see how they do here tonight. Brad Campbell's been having a little trouble outdoors after performing well indoors. Iron Outlaw's got the lead here. He's running a better race. Something's happened to Brad Campbell in the Monster Moose. He has broken. Monster Moose limping to a crawl there. He's got some real problems, but Iron Outlaw put together a pretty good run. Not sure what's going on with Campbell there. He has definitely got some motor problems. He's got it refired. He's going to bring it across the line in 24.182 seconds, 7.99 for Iron Outlaw. Tough break for Brad Campbell. We move on to our next qualifying run. It'll be Captain USA, driven by Jeff Bainter. Running with him will be Kelvin Raymer in the Natural High. Raymer put on quite a show in freestyle in round 17, doing a double slap wheelie, one of the most impressive moves seen in Monsters of Destruction freestyle this season. This is their qualifying run. We're waiting for them to go green. Off to a good start is Natural High into a wheelie there. That's going to slow him down. He misses his cars. Let's see his time, 7.692, barely beating Captain USA at 7.736. Narrowly missing a penalty there was Natural High. Our next qualifying run features Rick Swanson in the Line-X Obsession and Frank Scatini in Big Dummy. Pretty even so far. Looks like Big Dummy is pulling away now as they go across the second set of cars. A good run for Big Dummy. His time, 7.317. Rick Swanson, 8.294. Probably not what he was looking for in qualifying here tonight. A bit off the pace was Rick Swanson in the Line-X Obsession. Scatini was pretty impressive in round 17, his first MOD competition. And that brings us to Bigfoot, the last truck to qualify, driven by Dave Harkey. Bigfoot celebrating their 30th anniversary, and running with him will be Jimmy Creighton in the Bounty Hunter. Bounty Hunter swept straight line and obstacle racing in round 17. Let's see what he does here tonight. Bigfoot's got a good run going here. Bounty Hunter, a little bit of a wheelie that slowed him down. It's Bigfoot coming to the line first. His time, 7.228 seconds. Bounty Hunter off the pace at 8.015. Your qualifying results tonight, it's Bigfoot on top at 7.228, followed by Big Dummy, Natural High, Captain USA, Iron Outlaw, Bounty Hunter, Public Disturbance. Rounding out the field, it was Line-X Obsession and Monster Moose. This is heat number 1 of straight line drag competition here in round 18. Our 2 trucks coming to the line will be Brad Campbell and Monster Moose, who struggled in qualifying, going up against Frank Scatini and Big Dummy. The green light falls. Scatini looks good going over the first tabletop. He's pulling away. An impressive run. Big Dummy has eliminated Monster Moose. Big Dummy's time, 7.403. Monster Moose off the pace at 8.785. So Monster Moose, an early exit here in straight line drag competition in front of his hometown crowd here in Monroe, Washington. Look at Scatini using his motocross experience. He really gets that landing smooth, brings that nose down, lands evenly, keeps that forward momentum, and posts an impressive time here in round 1. Moving on to round 2, it's Natural High driven by Calvin Raymer going up against the Line-X Obsession of Rick Swanson. Looking back at round 17 in straight line drags, Natural High finished 7th, so he's looking to improve upon that here. Line-X not much better. He was 5th. The green light drops, pretty even so far. A little too much air for Natural High that time. slowed him down. Linex gets across the line first, a half a second better at 7.678 seconds. Natural high off the pace at 8.1. So Rick Swanson impresses here. He'll advance. Let's take another look at it. So Rick catches those front wheels and slams that rear end way up in the air. That could have slowed him down, but he was still fast enough to beat Natural High here tonight in round one. Monsters of Destruction on the Outdoor Channel is brought to you by AmeriGas, America's propane company, and by MonsterTruckStore.com, your online source for monster truck merchandise. This is heat number three of Straight Line Drag Competition. It'll be Jimmy Crete in the Bounty Hunter going up against Lindsey Wink in the Iron Outlaw. These are two very similar trucks, similar engines, similar wheelbases. Advantage, you might think, goes to Crete based on more experience, but let's see. The green light falls. Good jump for Iron Outlaw. He's actually got a lead, but it's Bounty Hunter over that first jump and pulls away his time, 7.476. Just a hair better than Iron Outlaw at 7.853. That was a pretty good heat, but Jimmy Creighton got it done. Over that tabletop clean, gets that rear end up in the air, just like we saw from Rick Swanson. Pulled away after the first jump, really got back on the gas early. Let's see where Iron Outlaw lost it. Kicked those rear wheels up big time. So Iron Outlaw lost it coming over that second jump. Moving on now to heat number four, it'll be Captain USA against Public Disturbance. Jason Grill trying to impress in front of his hometown crowd. Didn't qualify particularly well, but he's got a chance here going up against Captain USA. So it's Jeff Boehner against Jason Grill. Good start for both trucks, but Captain USA trying to pull away. Jason Grill not too bad. But he's not fast enough as Captain USA checks in with a time of 8.048. Public Disturbance off the pace at 8.9. All the trucks having trouble clearing those tabletops. Look at those rear wheels fly up off the ground. That slows a fella down, but good enough to get it done here tonight against Jason Grill. Our last heat will be a single run for Bigfoot, a golden opportunity for Bigfoot to gain in the season standings on Dragon Slayer, who took his truck to Alaska. He's not here tonight. So Bigfoot, a golden opportunity. Gets off the line clean. Nice over the tabletop. A lot of air there. Major distance brings it home. A nice run for Bigfoot. Dave Harkey checks in with an impressive time of 7.876. Bigfoot, a force to be reckoned with here tonight. So we move on to round two, heat number one of Straight Line Drags. It'll be Frank Scatini in the Big Dummy going up against Rick Swanson in the Linex Obsession. Both trucks carrying sponsorship from Linex. Scatini, we showed you in last week's show, drives that truck standing up. He's got kind of a ATV handlebar set up in the cab of that truck. Very unique in his driving style to avoid further injury to a bad lower back. Let's see how he does here against Swanson. Nice over the tabletop is Big Dummy. He wins going away. Scatini's time, 7.192, the best of the night. Rick Swanson, a good run, but not good enough at 7.589. So Frank Scatini moves on, an impressive run for Big Dummy here. He's got a lot of motocross experience. He really knows how to control the nose of that truck to bring it down even, keep his forward momentum going. Served him well there. Let's look at Linex. Hits those front wheels hard, gets a wheelie on the landing, slows him down a little bit. Didn't have the traction when he came off the tabletop and took a little while to get those wheels turning again. So here's heat two, round two. This will be Jimmy Creighton in the Bounty Hunter. He was impressive in round 17, winning straight line drags. He'll be going up against Captain USA and Jeff Boehner. Ooh, a bobble there for Jimmy Creighton, a little trouble, but he recovers and brings it home. His time, 7.413. Boehner not far behind at 7.518. A tough, heartbreaking loss for Jeff Boehner and Captain USA in a heat where Jimmy Creighton struggled a bit. We're going to take another look at it here in just a minute. He was able to save that truck and keep it moving forward. Let's look at it here. Catches those rear wheels on the tabletop, drifts way out to the right of his lane, but recovers enough to bring it home ahead of Jeff Boehner and Captain USA. Captain USA slamming those front wheels off the tabletop. It's a common theme here tonight. That's cost him some time. Just a tenth of a second separated him from victory. So we move on to heat number three now. It'll be Dave Harkey in the Bigfoot going up against Iron Outlaw, driven by Lindsey Wink. Good start for both trucks. But Wink pulling away now, and Iron Outlaw, something's gone wrong with Bigfoot. An impressive margin of victory for Iron Outlaw, 7.065. That's one of the fastest runs of the night. Something went bad wrong for Bigfoot, who finished a second and a half off the pace. So Lindsey Wink making a statement here in round 18 of MOD action, putting a hurting on Dave Harkey and Bigfoot. Let's take another look at Iron Outlaw's run. Kicks those rear wheels on the tabletop, but gets a lot of distance and bounces across the timing line. Bigfoot hits hard here after the tabletop, loses his momentum, and that was it. We'll be back with more on MOD after this. Welcome back to MOD on the Outdoor Channel. This is semifinal number one in straight line drag competition. It'll be Frank Scatini and Big Dummy going up against Jimmy Creighton and Bounty Hunter. Jimmy Creighton, this is his second MOD event. He won his first one. Big Dummy looking to make a statement here and knock off the reigning winner from last night's event. Big Dummy, wow, a lot of momentum coming off the tabletop. He just exploded forward. The fastest time of the night for Big Dummy, 6.945. What a great run. Bounty Hunter not bad at 7.1, but Scatini, an impressive run. This was awesome. He just shot away from that tabletop, gained a lot of speed on the landing. Let's look at Jimmy Creighton's run here in Bounty Hunter. The truck's just having a lot of trouble getting over the tabletop. Got some major distance over the second set of cars, but look at Scatini here. Just motors off that tabletop, using his motocross experience to his advantage to keep that forward momentum and advance to the finals. Moving on to semi number two, it's Lindsey Wink in the Iron Outlaw going up against Jeff Boehner and Captain USA. Both trucks performed well in round 17. Let's see how they do here. Iron Outlaw's got the lead, and he's pulling away. Lindsey Wink, an impressive run, 6.697, even faster than Big Dummy. Captain USA, 9.039. Wow, what a run for Iron Outlaw. He's going to give Big Dummy a run for his money in the finals. He put it in his eye right there, said, you can go 6.9, I can go faster. Let's look at Captain USA's run right here. Slams the front wheels down hard, barely hits the trucks, and he was assessed a 2-second penalty because he did not hit those blue cars clean at all. Cost him right there. Let's take a look at Iron Outlaw now. Clears the tabletop in the air, advances to victory with major distance, an impressive run for Iron Outlaw. Setting up our final now, it's Big Dummy Frank Scatini in the near lane going up against Lindsey Wink in Iron Outlaw. Round 17 won by Jimmy Creighton in Bounty Hunter. Will round 18 go to Iron Outlaw, or will it be Big Dummy? There's the green, pretty even over the tabletop, still even. But Iron Outlaw advances to victory as Big Dummy limped across the line. Iron Outlaw wins straight line drags. Lindsey Wink turning in a time of 6.855. Lindsey Wink and Iron Outlaw, who finished in ninth place in a field of nine trucks in round 17 straight line drag, turns it around, goes worst to first, winning here tonight. So Scatini bobbles on the tabletop, loses his momentum because he didn't clear it in the air, and something went wrong at the end there. Iron Outlaw, look at him clear the tabletop in the air. Major distance, his front wheels hit the finish line. What a great run for Iron Outlaw. Your results in straight line drags, it's Iron Outlaw, followed by Big Dummy, Bounty Hunter, Captain USA, Linex Obsession, and Bigfoot. The season point standings after 18 rounds look like this. It's Dragon Slayer on top, followed by Bigfoot, Monster Patrol, Spider-Man, and Linex Obsession. Fireworks fill the night sky here in Monroe. As we go to break, we'll be back with more after this. Monster. Welcome back to Evergreen Speedway in Monroe, Washington. It's obstacle course time here in MOD round 18 on the Outdoor Channel. Our first two trucks coming to the line. First is Kelvin Raymer in the natural high. He'll challenge Rick Swanson in the Linex Obsession truck. Rick Swanson's had some good runs in obstacle course racing here in MOD action. Kelvin Raymer, a relative newcomer to MOD. Let's see how this race plays out as we await the green. Good start start for both trucks. Linex to the turning tire first. Power slides around that turn, but has a little trouble. He has to correct, but he's still got a lead. He's over the tabletop. Can he save it? Wait a minute. He's out of his lane. He misses the cars. That's going to be a penalty to Linex Obsession. Natural High slower, but wins by virtue of the two-second penalty being assessed to Rick Swanson. I'm not going to say an impressive victory for Natural High, but he gets it done. Sometimes you got to keep it going straight and hope the other guy loses. Not so much a victory for Natural High, but a loss for Rick Swanson here. Let's take another look at it. Really takes his time getting around the turn. Finally back in the gas, barely in the air over the tabletop. Now he's back on the gas harder, gets some good air off the second set of cars. But Rick Swanson really had some trouble here in this run. Really fast to the turning tire, locks up the brakes and doesn't get the turn completed. You see him correct there. Up and over the tabletop he goes, and he drifts out of his lane, misses the cars altogether, and that costs him 2 seconds and the heat. Tough break for Rick Swanson there as we move on to heat number two. This will be Jason Grill in front of his hometown crowd. He's driving that public disturbance truck, going up against Jeff Boehner and Captain USA. Jason Grill looking to impress here. He gets a good jump. Captain USA around the turn. Completes it clean, but something went wrong there. He got off the gas. Jason Grill struggling. Boehner, he misses the cars as well. This course is eating him up and spitting him out here tonight at Evergreen Speedway. Jason Grill keeps it rolling. He has to stay within 2 seconds. Can he do it? No, he cannot. 21.103 for Jason Grill, even after the 2 second penalty to Captain USA. Jason Grill misses a golden opportunity here. Let's see what happens. Approaches the turn. He's way off the gas. Very cautious run here for Jason Grill. Just took way too much time completing that turn. No air over the tabletop. He's crawling here. Then he gets on the gas, clears the cars in the air, brings it home. He knew he had 2 seconds to play with. Let's look at Captain USA's run here. Charges that turning tire, cuts the turn. Something happened there, got off the gas, regains it, gets over the tabletop, drifts to the right, out of his lane, misses the line of cars completely, comes across the line with a 2 second penalty. But it was enough to beat Jason Grill here tonight. Disappointment for public disturbance, to say the least. Moving on to heat number three now, it'll be Frank Scatini in the big dummy going up against Brad Campbell, also in front of his hometown crowd. Let's see if he can do a little better. Big dummy's got a big jump here, reaches the turn first, carries it a little too far. He's way past the tire. He's out of his lane. Big dummy corrects now, gets over the tabletop. A lot of distance over that second set of cars and a good run for Big Dummy. His time, 15.156. He'll move on. Monster Moose off the pace by a half a second. So Big Dummy, who finished seventh in obstacle course racing in round 17, will do better than that here tonight. Let's take a look at Monster Moose's run. A good start off the green. Gathers it up to bring it around the turn. Gets around the turn pretty well. He's back on the gas right here. Up on top of that tabletop, it's very narrow up there. One miscalculation and you're off, but he executed it well. Just not quite fast enough for Brad Campbell. Now let's take a look at Scatini. You see him get on the brakes, goes way beyond that turning tire, drifts almost out of his lane. He's up on top of the tabletop, catches it with his rear wheels, flies over the second set of cars and brings it home victorious. Number four is a great matchup between Lindsey Wink in the Iron Outlaw going up against Jimmy Creighton in the Bounty Hunter. Round 17 was swept straight line and obstacle by Bounty Hunter. So far in round 18, Iron Outlaw has won the straight line drags. Iron Outlaw looking for a sweep here tonight, but he's going to have to beat his teammate Bounty Hunter if he wants to do it here at Evergreen Speedway in Monroe. Iron Outlaw quick off the line. He's got a little bit of a lead as they approach the tire. Creighton makes the turn better. Iron Outlaw has fallen behind. Bounty Hunter looks like he's going to take this one. It's going to be close, but Bounty Hunter, 14.412 seconds. Iron Outlaw, 2 tenths off at 14.634. That was a close race, ladies and gentlemen. So Bounty Hunter doing everything he can to prevent his teammate in the Iron Outlaw from sweeping here tonight. Let's take a look at Lindsey Wink's run. He had a good approach to the turning tire, but carried it way too far, drifts out to the outside of that lane, The tabletop gets him right here as he catches those rear wheels and slams the nose down, disrupting his forward momentum, slowing him down to allow Bounty Hunter to move forward. Here we see Jimmy Creighton with a clean turn around that tire. He hits the tabletop well and advances to victory. We've got more obstacle course action on MOD after these words. Heat 5 now of obstacle course racing. It'll be a single run for Bigfoot. Bigfoot came into tonight's action 43 points behind season leader Dragon Slayer. Dragon Slayer is not here, so a golden opportunity for Bigfoot to move up in the season standings. Gets around the turn fairly well, attacks that tabletop. Comes off the landing well, but gets off the gas, slowed down a little bit as he approached that second set of cars. His time, 14.598. One of the faster runs we've seen, despite the trouble he had getting over the tabletop. A good run for Dave Harkey and Bigfoot here. So we move on to the next round. It's heat number one. It'll be Frank Scatini in the big dummy going up against Kelvin Raymer in natural high. Natural high has demonstrated quite a skill for wheelies. I don't know how much that helps them in obstacle course racing, but he should be a treat in freestyle. Let's see what big dummy does here against natural high. Big dummy gets the hole shot. He's off the line strong, on the brakes, trying to get around that turning tire. They're pretty even at the turn. Big dummy over the tabletop. No air that time, but a lot of forward momentum. Big air going over the jump. Scatini wins. Look at that wheelie from Raymer. I told you he can do that, but it doesn't help him in obstacle course. Save it for freestyle, Calvin. Big dummy wins with a time of 14.934. So Frank Scatini and Big Dummy, who finished seventh in round 17, will improve upon that here tonight. He's got a good thing going here at Evergreen Speedway. Here we get a look at the natural high. Kelvin Raymer hits that turn. Sparks go flying from the rear of that truck. Cautious around the turn. Hits the tabletop square. Good air. Keeps his momentum going. Slaps the landing into a wheelie, a nice slap wheelie there, but he needs to save that for freestyle. He needs to go straight here in obstacle course racing. Scatini around the turn well. Carries the turn a little bit too wide, gets off the gas. No air over the tabletop, but a lot of momentum. You see him really accelerate coming off that tabletop to advance to victory in that heat. So heat number two, it'll be Jeff Bainter in Captain USA. He's in the near lane going up against Jimmy Creighton in the Bounty Hunter. He'll be in the far lane. Your winner in round 17. Captain USA finished fifth. He's got a chance to improve upon that performance here tonight. Creighton, a veteran of the Monster Jam series, a reigning freestyle champion. It's a real treat to have him here in MOD action. We hope he sticks around. Good start for Captain USA. Look at Bounty Hunter sliding through that turn. He's in trouble. He has to correct. He almost came back and hit the tire. Misses the tabletop as Captain USA into a slap wheelie, bringing it home. Captain USA wins going away. His time, 14.934. Bounty Hunter struggles with a time of 16.914. Impressive win there for Jeff Bainter. He really took advantage of a few critical mistakes by Jimmy Creighton. Here you see the start. Captain USA gathers it, gets around the turn well, carries it a little bit wide, gets off the gas, but gathers it back up, catches those rear wheels, bounces the landing. Had a wheelie going when he hit the second set of cars, but he managed to keep it together. Now let's take a look at Creighton. He carries way too much speed into the turn, slides around, has to correct there. Getting out of the gas there to correct really hurt him. Now he's back on the gas, slams the front of that truck down hard, but can't recover from the bobble. Carrying too much speed into the turn cost Jimmy Creighton right there. So heat number three looks like this. It'll be Dave Harkey in the Bigfoot. Bigfoot celebrating the 30th anniversary in the business, sporting the commemorative paint scheme, going up against Lindsey Wink in the Iron Outlaw. The trucks are staged. The green light falls, and Bigfoot gets a good jump here. But it's Wink that reaches the turn first. Bigfoot hits the tabletop first. Bigfoot's got a good run going here as Iron Outlaw gets some air over the tabletop, but Bigfoot pulls away over the second set of cars. Good distance in the air there. Bigfoot wins with a time of 14.449. Iron Outlaw, 14.923. He may get past this loser twice. He may not be done for the night. We'll have to wait and see how things play out. Here you see Bigfoot off the green. A lot of acceleration. Gathers it up. That rear wheel locks up, carries the turn well, approaches the tabletop. bounces it off the tabletop and really flies to victory there. A lot of distance off that second set of cars. A nice clean run for Dave Hartke and Bigfoot. Here we get a look at Lindsey Wink's run in Iron Outlaw. Carries this turn way too wide. He's out of his lane and out of shape. Kicks those rear wheels up off the ground, and that's what slowed him down. It's time for semifinal number one now. It'll be Frank Scatini and Big Dummy going up against Jeff Bader and Captain USA. Captain USA looked impressive in his last heat, but Big Dummy hasn't been a slouch either. They're both running well here tonight. This should be a very close, hotly contested matchup. The green light drops pretty even as they approach the turning tire. Big Dummy having a lot of problems in this turn. He's out of his lane, has to correct. He's off the gas, and while he's doing that, Captain USA is charging to victory. Jeff Boehner wins by a mile. A great run for Captain USA. His time, 15.084. Big Dummy, 4 seconds off the pace at 19.286. A tough break for Frank Scatini. These trucks are carrying so much speed on this straightaway. Let's take a look now at Big Dummy. Has to get on the brakes, locks up the rear wheels, and just drifts way outside. And by the time he gets it gathered up, the race is over. Finally, you know, those tabletops are very narrow, so he had to be careful. He didn't want to drift off to the side and miss this second set of cars and get a 2-second penalty. But as it is, he lost the race at the turn. Let's take a look at Jeff Boehner's run now. Handles the speed a lot better, gets around the turn clean. A little cautious, but a lot of air over the tabletop. The best way to get over that tabletop is to get over it in the air. You don't want to land up on top of that narrow container on top. So as the trucks are staging for semifinal number two, we're getting a report of an oil pressure problem for Dave Hartke and Bigfoot. Too risky to drive that truck here with no oil pressure. He doesn't want to burn out that motor, so they're going to tow him to the work area. We'll see if he can get it fixed for freestyle racing later in tonight's show. But this is a huge break for Iron Outlaw. As if he hasn't had enough breaks already tonight, Iron Outlaw was fastest loser twice in obstacle course racing, and now he could make the final. Lindsey Wink has to be thanking his lucky stars. Everything going right for him here tonight. A single run as Bigfoot can't take the start. Lindsey Wink can be a little bit cautious here. There you see, taking his time, gathering up the tabletop, saving the truck. Doesn't want to hurt the suspension. There's no need to do anything stupid here. A nice, efficient run for Lindsey Wink in the Iron Outlaw. His time, 15.413, not bad. Bigfoot doesn't finish, can't get off the line with that oil pressure problem. So the stage is set now for your obstacle course final here in MOD Round 18. It'll be Jeff Boehner and Captain USA challenging Iron Outlaw. Iron Outlaw, driven by Lindsey Wink, one straight line drags, looking to sweep here tonight as his teammate Jimmy Creighton in the Bounty Hunter did in Round 17. The green flag has fallen. Captain USA's got a good jump. Let's see. Pretty even around the turn, but Captain USA drifts wide, has to correct. That's a problem for him right there. He drifts out of his lane, coming across the tabletop, handing the victory to Iron Outlaw with a time of 14.741. Captain USA, 15 seconds flat. An impressive victory for Iron Outlaw here tonight, followed by Captain USA, Big Dummy, Bigfoot, Natural High, and Bounty Hunter. Our winner, Lindsey Wink, is standing by.
I'm here with Lindsey Wink. Lindsey, how'd you end up your winner tonight at the final? And you kind of got it here in a kind of an interesting way. How'd you end up here tonight?
Yeah, it seems like every race I had, I raced a good guy, but nonetheless, I didn't win. You know, I took the fast loser bracket all the way to the final. You know, it's not something I go around gloating about because you don't feel like you're the fastest truck here. But nonetheless, like, you got to stay in each race. You got to race to the win. You know, even if you're going to lose, you know you're going to lose. Got to make the fastest pass you can to try and come back as a fast loser and have a hope of making the next bracket. And, you know, I dodged a few bullets tonight and got into the final. And, you know, that's the only one I won. So I got to be happy with that.
Yeah, when you came out in the final, you definitely made the best of the situation. How'd your truck run tonight?
Ran awesome. You know, I got to thank Checker Shucks, Craig and Auto Parts Shucks up here in the Northwest. They really help us out. They make our trucks run so fast, and it's up to us to actually make them win.
Great. Well, hey, congratulations.
Thank you.
In the season standings, it's still Dragon Slayer on top, but Bigfoot gained some ground. He's followed by Monster Patrol, Spider-Man, and Monster Moose. Let's go back to the floor for a word with Jeff Boehner.
Jeff, runner-up tonight, but you had a good race. Tell us a little about your night.
Well, just this course is really tough. You couldn't really race this course. You had to go so easy into that turn, and and get straightened up. You couldn't, you know, like to race through the turns, and you could not race through those turns down there. Everybody's having a lot of trouble just lining up to even hit the second stack. But, you know, I think there's probably a lot of penalties missing the second stack with both front tires, but so many people were doing it, it all kind of evened out anyway. But good race in the final. We were happy to get there.
Stick around. We've got Freestyle MOD coming at you after these words. Time for Freestyle here in round 18 from Evergreen Speedway in Monroe, Washington. On the course right now, it's Kelvin Raymer in the natural high. Kelvin served notice last week in round 17 that he is a force to be reckoned with in that Chevy SSR replica truck body, executing a double slap wheelie last week that they're still talking about. Looks like he set one up right here. Attack the kicker. He's up in the air into a slap wheelie right there, but he's drifting. Had to bring it back down as he was drifting off to the right. A good start for Kelvin Raymer with a nice slap wheelie right there. This truck has the skid plate in the back. It's set up for wheelies, and he's going to do plenty of them here tonight in freestyle. Setting up his next move now is Kelvin Raymer. Over the tabletop. Gets on the gas and catches some good distance right there. Tries to get it into a slap wheelie on the landing, but not a lot of height on it. Ran out of real estate. Onto the race course here. Attack that kicker again where he got the good slap wheelie last time by. On the gas. Major air. He's got the wheelie going. He's on the tailgate. Look at the distance on that slap wheelie. A great move from Kelvin Raymer. Kelvin's got that natural high running well here tonight. He's thinking about quitting. That truck is still running, though. He throws it in reverse. Maybe he's not done yet. Two exciting wheelies from the natural high, but he's going to have to set the bar a little higher than that if he wants to win freestyle. Maybe a donut, maybe some high air here. This thing's not really set up for the big air. It is set up for wheelies. I don't know what he's doing out there. Maybe he's just showing off right now. He's had two pretty good moves. Maybe he's thought better of it. The truck might be hot. He is done. He unbuckles, waves to the crowd here at Evergreen Speedway. Some impressive moves, but I'm afraid they were too few and far between to win freestyle here tonight, but impressive nonetheless. Look at the air on that. Slaps it into a wheelie, holds it for a considerable distance. He's on the tailgate right there. Half the straightaway, a great move from Kelvin Raymer. Here you get a look at his other wheelie. This was the first one. He could have kept it going for a lot of distance, but he was drifting to the right. He was going to hit that second stack of cars. There he waves to the crowd here in Monroe. A pretty good performance, but I don't think enough substance to it. He had some flashy moves, but all in all, he needs to do more. Here comes Jimmy Creighton in the Bounty Hunter. Up and over that first stack. Jimmy Creighton looking to do some damage here in freestyle. A lot of speed for Creighton here in the Bounty Hunter. This is your reigning Monster Jam world champion of freestyle. I'm sure he's got something special for us here tonight. Attacks that first kicker, slaps the landing. He's got a wheelie going, major distance. He almost lost it, but kept it going. Brings it down, runs into the turning tire. Jimmy Creighton, a nice wheelie right there, and he carries it so far. He comes down on the tire, no damage to that Bounty Hunter truck. Looking good here in freestyle is Jimmy Creighton in the Bounty Hunter. He's got plenty of time left. Look at him attack that ramp backwards, perpendicular, way up in the air, straight up and down. That was a good move right there for Jimmy Creighton. Setting up his next move now. Attacks the stack. Decent distance right there. Freestyle world champion looking to put some more moves on the table here before he retires for the night in freestyle in round 18. A lot of speed, carries some distance in that truck, not a lot of height. So far, the wheelie over the kicker is best move. Going into a donut here. It's a right-hander. He's got it hooked up. Dust is flying. What a great donut here from Jimmy Creighton. Seven or eight turns. The dust flies. The crowd reacts. What a great freestyle performance from Bounty Hunter. He's looking strong here tonight. Moving up to attack that kicker. This is where he got that good wheelie going. Time for his finishing move. Slams the front down. He's got the wheelie going. He's riding high. Another fine slap wheelie from Jimmy Creighton in the Bounty Hunter. Parks it in front of the crowd as the crowd reacts. He'll lean out of that Bounty Hunter truck and wave to the crowd. The crowd's going crazy here at Evergreen Speedway. A great freestyle run from Jimmy Creighton in the Bounty Hunter. Let's take another look at his first lap wheelie. Good air, on the gas, got it way up high on the tailgate, carries it for half the length of the speedway and more. Has to bring it down because he's running into that tire. No damage to the Bounty Hunter. Keeps it going into a right-handed donut right here. This is a great tight donut. The dust goes flying, and Jimmy Creighton, impressive here in freestyle. We'll be back with more on MOD after this. Welcome back to Monsters of Destruction on the Outdoor Channel. Some pretty good freestyle so far, a lot yet to come. This is Jason Grill in public disturbance in front of his hometown crowd. Up and over the tabletop he goes. Jason Grill not known for his freestyle prowess, but let's see what he can do with some home cooking here in Monroe, Washington. Still calculating his first move, hasn't really done much yet. Up and over the van stack, not bad there, slams the front down. A little cautious for Jason Grill here. He's on the gas now. He's gonna bring it down and swing it around, set up his next move. Got it turned around now. Let's see which stack he'll attack here. Catches a little air over the bank there. Setting up the next stack on the gas. A little bit of distance there for Grill. On the tabletop now. About half his time left. Jason Grill here in freestyle. Looking to get some things done here. Setting up for a jump on the van stack now as he approaches. On the gas. Whoa, nice there. Gets some air. Comes down hard on those white cars. Got that public disturbance truck 90 degrees to the ground. A little bit of height there for Jason. So far, Bounty Hunter's got him beat, but Jason Grill showing some improvement here in freestyle in Monroe, Washington. So Jason Grill's freestyle run is complete. Taking a little bit of a parade lap in front of this big crowd here in Monroe. Here's his best move. 90 degrees up in the air, comes down hard. Not a lot of distance there, but he got it straight up and down. Biggest air we've seen yet from Jason Grill this season in freestyle right here. So Jason getting some valuable seat time, learning a few things here, attacks the van stack, the most aggressive freestyle move we've seen him make, and that sets the stage for Brad Campbell. Brad Campbell also in front of his hometown crowd. His most impressive freestyle performance was probably back in Glendale, Arizona indoors. He was getting some major air over the center tabletop there. I think it was round 7. Let's see what he's got here at Evergreen Speedway. Takes out the ramp there, tries a slap wheelie but couldn't hold it. Got some decent air over that kicker. Does Brad Campbell. He's carrying the sponsorship from the Outdoor Channel. That's the Monster Moose. Setting up this tabletop here. Cautious. Carries some speed there. Good distance for him right there. A little bit of a wheelie on the landing. Up against the turning wall there. He's going to come back across the track. Get some air. He's got some speed going. Approaching this stack. Good air right there. Looks like he's trailing some fluid behind that Monster Moose. He may have some damage to that thing. Maybe a mechanical problem, but it's still running okay. Over that stack clean. Brad Campbell setting up this kicker. That's where everybody's done a lot of their damage. Let's see what he's got right here. Good air. Tries a slap wheelie, but just can't get it up in the air. Attacks that stack horizontally, went across it at a 90-degree angle. That's not what you normally see. An interesting move. Brad trying to do anything he can to excite this crowd here at Evergreen Speedway. Tried something different right there. A little bit of air on that stack. He's knocked that body a little bit out of kilter. I'm not sure if he's got a suspension problem or if he just knocked the body. He's kind of leaning to the left a little bit. So Campbell is done, but we've got more freestyle after these words on the Outdoor Channel. Merchandise. Taking the track now is Rick Swanson in the Linex Obsession Truck. You watched round 17. You saw him do a great tandem run with Jimmy Creighton, the bounty hunter. But I think Rick is a little happier tonight. He's got the stage all to himself. Let's see what he can do with it. Good distance on that jump right there. He's known for donuts. He's known for big air. Still getting going here tonight in freestyle. Attacking that kicker. Open for a slap wheelie there. Didn't get it going. Turns it right 90 degrees and attacks the stack from the side. He's going to keep it going and do it again. Mixing it up here at Evergreen Speedway is Rick Swanson. Hearing that Minex sponsorship. Looking over that stack right there, not a lot of height. Top of the tabletop now. He's going to have to step it up if he wants to win here tonight. We've seen some good performances by Jimmy Creighton and Natural High especially. Bounty Hunter and Natural High have set the bar. Whoa, look at this. Up and over backwards, that big ramp. Got some major air there, stood it straight up and down, an impressive move. Had to punish him physically on the landing. That didn't look like it felt too good. Approaches that stack with some speed, gets some distance. Up on top of the container now and back down over the tabletop. Once it's got a little bit of time left. Over the tabletop he goes. Nice distance there for Swanson. Aggressive turn there, got one of the wheels off the ground. Backs the stack one more time. Going into a donut here. Got it hooked up, pretty tight turns. Not as fast as Bounty Hunter on the Revolutions, but a pretty good donut here on the bank surface from Rick Swanson in the Linux Obsession. A nice finishing donut for Rick. He parks the truck, the crowd acknowledges him, he unbuckles, waves to the folks here at Evergreen Speedway. Decent freestyle performance from Rick Swanson in the Linux Obsession truck. So here comes Captain USA, Jeff Boehner into a slap wheelie right out of the gate. Holds it the length of the straightaway. This is a tandem run as we try to finish strong here on MOD Freestyle. Lindsey Wink in the Iron Outlaw with Jeff Boehner and Captain USA. And Captain USA has a flat left front tire. A short but sweet run for Captain USA. It's up to Iron Outlaw and Lindsey Wink now to carry the banner for the remainder of Freestyle. A tough break for the fans and Captain USA right there, but a great slap wheelie in the limited amount of time he did run in Freestyle. Here's Iron Outlaw. Tries for a slap wheelie, can't hold that one. Iron Outlaw, your winner in straight line drag and obstacle course racing here from Evergreen Speedway in round 18. Big air right there over the van stack, bounces the landing, and a donut. Captain USA not ready to give up, tries to put it into a donut with a flat tire and actually made a few turns right there. Iron Outlaw still going at it. Lindsey Wink looking to finish strong here from Monroe, Washington. Setting up a slap wheelie here. Big air, slaps the landing, can't hold the wheelie. He's given it his all here tonight, but Iron Outlaw unable to perform the wheelie right there over that kicker. Let's see what he's got left. Big tabletop jump, major air right there, way off the surface here at Evergreen Speedway. A lot of dust being kicked up into a donut. He goes, a right-hander. Nice donut here from Lindsey Wink. Drifts a little bit down the bank part of the speedway during the donut. He's going to park it. He is done. An impressive freestyle performance from Lindsey Wink in the Iron Outlaw, your winner in straight line drag and obstacle course racing here tonight. He climbs out of that truck, waves to the crowd to finish a great night of monster truck action here in round 18. Here's Captain USA slap wheelie, first move of his run. Look at the distance on that thing. Great height, carries it the length of the speedway, brings it back down, and then suffers a flat tire. Big air from Iron Outlaw right here, going over that tabletop jump, some 15 feet to the racetrack surface. Over the van stack he goes. Good distance, major air right there. Iron Outlaw putting on a good show to finish things here from Evergreen Speedway. Into a donut he goes. A great way to finish things here in round 18 from Evergreen Speedway in Monroe, Washington. For everyone here at the Outdoor Channel, this is Wade Sherman reminding you, there are men, there are machines, and then There are monsters of destruction.